Assalamu alaikum. Bayo, bayo. I haven't really learned anything. What little I have comes purely from the rahmah of Allah. And what you have, everything comes from the rahmah of Allah. One of the questions that people ask me constantly is, how did you become a Muslim? And I never really know how to answer that, because it depends on the person who's asking, how many hours they want me to talk. I read a lot as a child, and I really, really, really loved adventure books. And I loved the ones where the Muslims came and they said, say la ilaha illallah. You know, you have to become a Muslim or we kill you. So I loved those books. And then I was thinking, when I was reading like that, that by reading it, did I become a Muslim? Because by reading, I said la ilaha illallah. It was, you know, it was just that way. And then later, I found out from my Sheikh Al-Muhayyadeen that I was always a Muslim since Alam al-Arwa, since that time. And we were all together in that beautiful world of souls where there was no difference. There was nobody compelling anybody to be anything. We were all saying la ilaha illallah together in unity, just like we are here, brothers and sisters, uncles and aunties. When I came to Bawa, I had been looking for many, many years of my life. I wanted God beyond anything else, just God. All my childhood, I was just saying, God, God, where is God? And my mother was not very religious, but she believed in God, so she always said, God will do it, God will come. But she did try to make me a Christian, but I refused. I couldn't do it. I just couldn't do what was required, but I wanted God. So then I went to various churches. They didn't have what I wanted. I went to a synagogue and the people said, no, you're not old enough. You come back when you're 18. And I went to, you know, so many places that were available to me at that time, which were not very many. So I was looking and looking and looking. And then I had a newspaper at that time. I was in my early 20s. And my newspaper was meant to bring people together so they did not fight about religion. So they could all be together as one people. And like, I wanted to show them that there was only one God. Even though I wasn't a Christian, I wasn't Jewish, I wasn't Muslim at that time, not that I knew, I didn't know I was a Muslim at that time, but I had a small thought, but I did say la ilaha illallah, uh-huh. And the book said that was the condition. So then I had that newspaper and I was going to an interview. I was gonna do an interview with a famous radio personality. And made the appointment, and he said, called me up and said, well, I can't come to the interview because I have met the true guru. And I said, oh, can I come? And the minute he said those words, the true guru, I knew that that was the true guru. So I walked in Bawa's room with him. And at that time, Bawa's instructions were, bring everybody up, because hardly anyone was coming. No one in America had heard of him. He came, he was elderly and frail, and he came all the way from Sri Lanka because one person had written him a letter saying that she wanted to know God. And I came into his room and my heart started beating. And it was saying, it's a saint, it's a saint, it's a saint, this is a saint. And he was in meditation at the time. And the most peace I have ever felt in my life, I stepped into his room and it was like going into another world. It was not this dunya anymore. And then little by little, I got to know him and I got to see him. And I didn't even know, I knew who he was, but I didn't know what I needed to do with who he was. Because he was so so pure, so different from anybody else I had ever met. But I knew him. He was just amazing, and is, continues to be. Then I asked him if I could study Tamil. And he said yes. Yes, and he said it with a beautiful smile on his face, the most beautiful smile. And then he let me study. I went to Sri Lanka and I studied and studied. I studied day and night until my eyes were infected. Like just studied and studied. I couldn't stop. And you know, along with Tamil, of course, he also had used Arabic words, Urdu words, Persian words. You can hear them if you listen to the discourses. So I was studying and studying, and then we came back to America. And that was maybe about 6 or 7 or 8 months after I met him. And he asked me to translate, and I said, how? Because Tamil is, it's considered the most difficult language in India to learn. Mm-hmm. Of course. And I said, how am I gonna translate? You know, I don't know how. He said, try. So I tried and tried and tried. And I kept going to him and saying, what does this word mean? What does that word mean? What does the next word mean? And there was a time when every time I asked him what the word meant, he told me, oh, that means grace. That means Rahma. Went for the next word. Oh, that means grace. That means Rahma. So after about 10 words that I asked him, I was thinking, okay, they all mean Rahma. But he meant that it had to come from Rahma. But I didn't know at the time. So then one day I heard that one of the elders had learned to read Tamil, because Bawa put his hand on her head. And the minute I heard her say that, I ran to Bawa and I said, if you want me to translate, then you have to put your hand on my head. I cannot do it. I cannot do it any other way. So he looked at me very, very seriously. And he put his hand on my head and kept it there for about 5 minutes. And it was as if a book had opened inside me. And I could read that book when he spoke. And I don't know how else to describe it. It was
miracle.
It was a miracle. It was an absolute, like, you know, it sounds silly to say I'm Bao's miracle. Here it is. So alhamdulillah, I've talked long enough. Amin, amin, ya Rabbil alameen.
Make dua for four of us.
Okay.
A'udhu billahi minash shaitani rajeem. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. May Allah bless all of you with the wisdom to understand more and more every day, to understand who you are, who God is, and most of all, who your brothers and sisters are. Because Baba said he didn't come to America to create a fellowship. He said, all the children of Adam are your fellowship. Every child of Adam is your brother and sister. So may we know that unity, may we know that love. May we be together. May we beg God for peace in the world, peace in our families, peace at our jobs, peace everywhere.
Amen.
Inshallah.
Amen.
Amen. Ya Rabbi.